Hello everyone, my name is Bobby Kendrick Magali and Abid, and our topic is will drone ship sail the seven seas? So Rolls-Royce has attempted to create a drone, an unmanned drone cargo ship. The purpose of this is to increase efficiency and cost effectiveness for shipping internationally. The VP for Innovation, Oscar Lavander, he's leading the initiative to accomplish this idea by getting funding from the European Union, who's volunteered 3.5 million euros in order to help find out if the study is even feasible at all. So I'm going to turn it over to Kendrick, and he's going to give you the pros and cons.
Now, like every situation, there are pros and cons, as Bobby has said. And most of the cons that people are looking at are safety issues. And the two main safety issues that have been talked about were system failures and error, not necessarily error recognition, but adaption to error. For although the drone may be programmed to deal with something, there's always a human intake where we can just think things through and maybe adapt to it a different way that the drone might not be able to adapt to. However, the pros of this, the drone though, is one thing, so there wouldn't be an error that needed to be adapted to. The drone, like just cameras in general, are much better than the human eye, or far superior to them during night or fog or mist. So a drone might be able to recognize an iceberg or maybe even on the radar much more quickly than a human or a crew member could. And as to the way system failures go, there is an automatic safe mode that would take the drone and just guide it back towards where it came from or whichever closer the destination was, so it doesn't just get, like, you know, just float, wander, like, aimlessly. And the biggest pro of drones, though, is although there will just be cargo on the ship, since there aren't any humans on the ship itself is less likely to come under fire attack. And even if it does come under fire attack, there won't be any hostages that we have to worry about. So with that, I turn it over to the dog.
So having a drone operator shift would greatly increase the efficiency of the company, because there would be many great decrease in the operating expenses, especially because having crew on board takes up 44% of the operating expenses, because along with the crew, they need to have their accommodations to be able to stay on the ship. And getting rid of all those accommodations would make the ships 5% lighter and will save 15% of fuel. And companies can really take advantage of that. For that 5%, they can put more cargo where they can just save that money. And as Kendrick mentioned about the pirates, since there's less incentive for the pirates to attack the ships, then more ships will be making it to their destination with their cargo. And some of the knowledge that we can apply is since we are majoring in supply chain management, these drone operated cargo ships are still being debated, so they might actually become a thing later on while we're working in the supply chain.
So the International Convention actually said that unmanned drone ships are illegal. If they don't comply with the rules, then they're considered unseaworthy or ineligible. And the International Transport Workers Federation said that the human aspect is the first line of defense. So, you know, we can adapt to sudden changes or unexpected changes or conditions. Like Kendrick mentioned, there's going to be a safety feature, but there's a certain thing that technology can't really adapt to or even just consider. One thing that we learned is that with drone ships, they would be taking a lot of jobs. Obviously, for a business aspect, it would cut a lot of expenses, and that's obviously positive, but with all the unemployment, you know, it might not help as much as a broader